So I was wrong about JoJo Bizarre Adventures.
What was that for? How dare you?
JoJo has always been an interesting story to say the least. It's a highly influential one, where it's hard to describe exactly what it's about. You see, every JoJo part is so different from the one before it, it's like it's an entirely different anime. You could absolutely despise part 1 of JoJo, yet love part 2. And I think the biggest example of this is JoJo part 4. The amount of differences from this part over any other part in the story is extremely mind-blowing. You look at part 1, and then part 2, and then part 4, and it looks like it's practically a completely different show. Now, my personal history with JoJo is a little bit shaky. Without further ado, let's get into why I was wrong about JoJo Bizarre Adventures. I used to hate JoJo. Yes, you heard that correctly. You see, I was in a state of mind where like a quarter of my class was watching it, calling it one of the greatest animes of all time. So me being the cultured weeb I am, I decided to watch it. And let me tell you, part one of JoJo kind of sucks. I mean, the villain named Dio is cool. Even the whole entirety of the first two episodes aren't necessarily bad. But once you get into the power system called Hammond, it's kind of uninteresting. It's just more or less boring. Following that, the show has terrible pacing. It just turns into a very boring long watch without any really interesting aspects to it except Dio, and kind of Speed Bagone. Anyway, after persevering through part 1, I finally got to part 2. The part that everyone said was one of the best. So I decided to keep watching it, and I'm gonna be honest, I should have enjoyed it a little bit more. You see, after the foul taste part 1 left in my mouth, I already viewed this part fairly low, just because of that. But I still kept watching, and honestly, it wasn't bad. I still disliked JoJo, though, because of the taste and the flavor part 1 gave me. It was just so bad. Now, JoJo part 2, in my opinion, had fairly boring villains, but has one of the more interesting JoJos. At the same time, the pacing issues are fixed, but I am sorry, Hammond is still boring as crap! Anyway, I kept moving forward, because everybody was telling me about the light at the end of the road. That light was Stans. So I watched JoJo Part 3. Oh yeah, I dropped that by episode 10. You see, Part 3 had an amazing villain back again, Dio. It had a cool power system called Stans. However, its pacing issues were back again. They were garbage. I did end up watching the OVAs though about JoJo Part 3 to basically get the story still and a better paced version more or less. Anyway, this is the point where I kinda gave up on JoJo. I had decided to completely drop the show and kind of throw away. However, about a year later, I finally decided to pick JoJo back up and watch Part 4 with one of my friends that was a JoJo stan. That was kind of bad, I'm kind of sorry with that. Anyway, on back to the video, pretty much immediately I fell in love with part 4. This wasn't like any of the other parts which had weaknesses. This part had almost a perfect pacing, a fantastic villain named Akira, a good main character named Josuke, the side characters were all interesting, and above all, it continues the Stans power system which I am in love with. If that wasn't interesting enough, it was completely different from the other JoJo's. The main difference was in JoJo Part 4, the villains. Kira isn't a world-ending vampire, or a being which threatened the existence of the universe. But instead, he is a simple serial killer which wants to live a normal life, but has a urge to murder. I'm not done watching JoJo Part 4, and I don't know everything about Kira, but I can already tell you that Kira is an amazing villain and how the show is amazing. Anyway, from here on out, I will be tweeting episode by episode reactions, so if you're interested, you can follow me on Twitter at @emperor_poxal, or you can join my Discord server where we just talk about anime. Anyway, the final thing I want to get in on Part 4 of JoJo is it takes the previous characters and improves them. It's really unique to see how Part 4 takes the JoJo's from Part 3 into and actually makes me like them more. The bond between Joseph and Josuke is so heartwarming, I love it. And the more serious Jotaro in Part 4, I like more than the one in Part 3. His new design is also superior in my eyes. Anyway, that's the video. I love JoJo now, and I'm genuinely excited to finish Part 4 and move forward to Part 5, as I hear a lot of people praising that one. Anyway guys, my name is Poxal, signing off.